Light switches like this are very common. Yours may look different depending on which country you are in, but basically there are only three different types of switches, particularly in the UK. The first switch that we're going to look at is a one gang one way. These are all one gang switches. The gang is the number of switches on the back plate. So if you had one of those with two switches, that would be a two gang. But all of these switches that I have here are all single gang switches. This is the most basic type of light switch. This is a one gang one way. So in there's a contact. When you flick the switch, it makes the contact and completes the circuit. On the back, you simply have a COM terminal and the L1 terminal. When you flick the switch, it breaks the contact. When you flick the switch again, it makes the contact, which completes the circuit, switching the light on. So that is the most basic switch you can get. A lot of places don't stock these now. They will stock the two-way switch instead, which can still be used for a one-way light. We now come on to the single gang two-way switch. Again, this has got contacts inside of there. We've got a COM, L1 and L2. I have done a video on how to wire a two-way lighting circuit, and that should help you how to fully understand it. And I've also done a video on how to wire a three-way lighting circuit, which should also help. So this can be used on a two-way lighting system by using the COM, L1 and L2 terminals. If you just want to use it as a one-way switch, you simply put one of the wires in COM, and it doesn't really matter which other terminal you put it in. You can either put it in L2 or L1, it will still work. So that is a one gang two-way switch, which will be used on either a one-way switching circuit or a two-way switching circuit. A two-way switch doesn't really have a on or an off position. It is either in the L1 position or the L2 position, depending on where the switch is. This is also a one gang two-way switch, but that is slightly different in that the COM is at the bottom on this switch. So the COM's there, you then got the L1 and L2, although they are marked up slightly differently on this switch. The most versatile of all of the switches is the intermediate switch. This is a very versatile switch. This can be used for one-way switching, two-way switching, three-way switching, or even more than three-way switching. This is a very clever switch. At the top there we've got L1, L1, and at the bottom we've got L2, L2. If you want to wire this up for a one-way system, choose any of the top terminals and any of the bottom, and that will give you your on-off switch on a single circuit. You can also wire this up on a two-way circuit by using one of the top terminals as the COM and the two bottom terminals, one as L1 and one as L2. Or you can do it the other way around. You can choose the top as L1 and L2 and either of the bottom ones as COM. That way you can use that on a two-way lighting circuit. Obviously on a three-way lighting circuit you will be using all four terminals. But that just goes to show how versatile this switch is. You can simply use it for one-way switching, two-way switching, or three-way switching, or even more than three-way switching if you want. If you've ever wondered what's in the back of there, there's nothing remarkable in there. It's simply some little contacts that open or close the circuits. So we're just going to take a look inside of this one, which is the two-way one. So if we take a look in there, you can see that that is the COM terminal, and then we've got the L1 and the L2. And what happens when you press the switch is, it moves that tiny little contact there, and that contact either moves between that terminal there or that terminal there, which alters the circuit. So it's either in L1 or in L2, depending on where the switch is. So like I said, there's not a lot to look at inside of an actual switch. It's simply a couple of terminals with a contact in between, which is moved by the switch when you flick the switch. I hope this video has been useful in explaining how light switches work. If you have found it useful and you haven't done so already, please subscribe to the channel.